My name is Matthew, but my tag is Mystery, and I'm on Instagram as Mystery973. That's spelled M-I-S-T-E-R-Y 973. Initially, I started hip hop as a b-boy back in the early 1980s. A few movies came out. There were some music videos, and they had hip hop culture as like the elements of hip hop culture in it. And the initial thing that attracted all of my generation was breaking first. So we started b-boying, and then we noticed that in the movies they had graffiti as well, and rapping and DJing and stuff. So we just thought if you were a b-boy, you did graffiti or you rapped. We didn't realize that there were sort of specialties that people focused on specifically. And so started doing graffiti just to sort of like augment my breaking, you know. But I was a little bit more natural at graph than I was at breaking, and so over time that became my specialty. But also I've continued to MC, like I still rap and that as well, you know. So graffiti in essence is an illegal act, you know. Just even the nature of the word, you know, that's where I started, that's where most people have started at some stage. But you know, now I'm a bit older, you know, I'm a little bit more respectable. You know, so I do it as a career, but not to take away from where it started, you know. And I still work with a lot of young people that are involved in illegal graffiti, you know. And I'm not even here to tell them don't do illegal graffiti. I'm just here to say, if you choose to do legal stuff, this is how you go about it, you know, because, you know, one hand washes the other. How it went in like the history of Australian hip hop, everyone was b-boys at the beginning. There was like this sort of fad of breaking that lasted just a few years, and a lot of those b-boys started to focus specifically on graffiti. And so for many years, Australia was one of the leading countries in graffiti, and there were graffiti artists all around the nation, you know. It still is very strong, and now the graffiti scene sometimes is just a world of its own. There will be thousands of graffiti writers in Sydney. But also, you know, for people like me and for others that are interested in hip hop, we do it because we're part of hip hop. But there would be a lot of dancers, breakers, whatever, that have no connection to graffiti as well. No MCs that have connection to graffiti. But the way we got it in Australia was through, you know, a whole package. If you look at the history of graffiti in New York, graffiti existed before hip-hop even was invented. And so, yeah, we were sort of a nation that was known for graffiti, especially because of magazines. There were a lot of graffiti magazines, like Hype Magazine and Vapors, and there was a few other ones around the country initially, and then there were more and more after that, you know. In a way, graffiti is its own world. Like, there's people that do graffiti that aren't connected to hip hop at all nowadays. But then again, there's people like myself, and there's a few others that we love doing graffiti, but we also love hip hop culture in general. And then again, you know, now added to that, you've got sort of like term street art, which there's people, they might go to art school or something like that, but they like graffiti, so they sort of go the other way. They don't go from a hip hop crime aspect, they go from like an art aspect into graffiti. Whereas for myself and for a lot of the OGs and people that are hip hop heads, we went that way, you know, from hip hop into graffiti specifically. When I got into graffiti, it was initially a mentorship thing. I mean, initially, to be perfectly honest, there was very little resources. So my generation, we would go to the cinema and watch movies like Beat Street and Breakin'. Breakin' had terrible graffiti in it, but anyway, we went and watched it, and we would try and remember what it looked like and then go home and draw it. So needless to say, we were crap for ages. But then Rocksteady Crew came out with a song called Hey You, the Rocksteady Crew, and they were b-boys, and there was a b-girl or singer in the group. The album covers were done by one of the members, Devious Doze, or Doze Green as he's known now, and they were graffiti style, and so we just copied them. And then later on, a book called Subway Art came out, which is basically the Bible of graffiti. Like, it explained everything. And for people, not just in Australia, but Europe and Africa, we all got Subway Art, and that taught us everything. But nowadays you've got the internet, you've got so much information. You've got tutorials on can control, on how to use cans. For myself as well, I sort of fell into teaching. I don't think hip-hop's something you can teach. I think you've got to experience it. There, you can give people tips along the way. And so, you know, here at Street Uni, I run graffiti classes, and I'll do everything from like teaching about lettering to teaching how to do characters to teaching how to get a legal wall, how to plan a mural, like all of it, you know. And so there's places online, community centers, and also just connecting with a crew and like learning from a crew, you know, because I still think that personal interaction is always the best. You can learn dance tutorials on the net. Not the same as being part of a dance crew, you know. Well, graffiti art in the sort of pure sense is connected to hip hop. The package that I got, not the pre-hip hop graffiti from New York and that, but the hip hop that I do, it's mainly focused on lettering. That's why we're called graffiti writers, not graffiti artists, because we write our name. Spray paint as a medium, like that's our main sort of thing that we use, or for people that are tagging and stuff like that, we markers or whatever, different things. But I mean, art is a broad term, man. Art is like, what is art is like one of those how long's a piece of string questions. And if you see something in spray paint and it's a tag name, that's pretty much usually graffiti. Nowadays, street art is sort of intertwined in some people's minds. I sort of see them as two separate things. For me, I actually paint characters as well. So I do all different sorts of stuff, you know. I did a little bit of work as a comic artist, graphic designer, like you name it, fine arts. Even though I paint images, I still know that it's about the lettering, and I still consider myself a graffiti writer first and foremost in regards to my identity as a visual artist, you know? I always get asked that question. I don't know. It really depends. Like, I've got paintings that I've done that are a little bit more timeless. They're a little bit more classic. They still look good many, many years later. But then again, sometimes I'll do something and I love it, and then 5 years down the track, I'll realize that it's actually not that great. It just depends, you know. As an artist, you have, I think you have like a honeymoon period where like I'll do a painting and I'll drive out of my way to go past it, so I could look at it and go, yeah, I did it. But then 5 years down the track, I don't even turn my head when I drive past it. It's just sort of like, you just get over it. For me, like, you know, hip hop's about battling. I've always really been focused on the battle being against myself. And so I'm always striving to do a better piece every time. Even if I'm doing something quick, I'll never do something, you know, half-ass. I'm still battling against myself, you know, losing most of the time. No, sometimes I win. Yeah, so I teach at the Street University. In Liverpool. There's street unions all around the place, but I'm based in Liverpool. And also I run a ministry called Crosswords, and that's spelled K-R-O-S-S-W-E-R-D-Z. And that's a hip hop sort of community, faith-based hip hop community. And so yeah, just crosswords.com. So K-R-O-S-S-W-E-R-D-Z.com. Sweet, no worries. All good in the hood.
Wow.